We're going to complete our work on the module of the optics of the eye by discussing for just a few minutes the issue of magnification. We all know what magnification is. It's taking something which is actually one size and creating the impression that it is in fact much larger. And this is typically done with glasses with optical systems. We have four types of magnification. We have relative size magnification, relative distance magnification, angular magnification, and electro-optical magnification. We're going to take each one of these individually. We'll begin with relative size magnification. The classic example of relative size magnification is large print. Print is typically measured by points, and most newspapers are considered somewhere between 8 and 10 point print. And if we wanted to enlarge it, we would simply take it up to 20 point print. Double its size, two times magnification. So large print is, in fact, a quite simple example of relative size magnification. Another next type is called relative distance magnification. And relative distance magnification is the following. If you are reading the newspaper at 15 inches, which is the distance at which approximately the distance at which most of us read our newspaper, and then you bring that newspaper to 7 1/2 inches, you are going to be doubling the magnification, two times magnification, because you've cut the distance in half. In fact, when we use really high-powered reading glasses, these microscope reading glasses that we've been discussing in some of our other modules, those microscopic glasses do not magnify as much as they focus. When a person is reading material that's right up near their nose, the glasses do not magnify. The magnification comes from relative distance. What the glasses do is they focus the print so that, in fact, you can read it. Another example, that's one that you, I'm sure, have all experienced, is that you're standing 30 feet from something. I've simply said a street sign, but it could be anything. And you're trying to see it, and you just can't quite see it. So you get closer. To keep the math simple, I have us going to 15 feet here. And at 15 feet, we double our magnification. We've made the sign twice as large. But certainly we could come just a little bit closer, 20 feet or 25 feet, and that also gives us the concept of magnification. But the math gets a little more complicated there from the point of view of what we're trying to cover right now. Relative distance magnification. The third type of magnification is known as angular magnification, and this comes from a telescope. In a telescope, you have a series of lenses as well as a series of prisms. And by inverting and minimizing and magnifying and reinverting that image, what comes out of the other end of the telescope is magnification. So if you have a pair of binoculars, the most common pair would be a 7 by 30 or 7 by 50 pair of binoculars, field binoculars. The 7 is a 7 power. It magnifies the images by 7 power. It also, another way of looking at it, is that it makes the images or makes the objects come 7 times closer than they in fact really are. Angular magnification. And our last type of magnification is known as electro-optical magnification. And the classic example of this is the closed-circuit television system. Most people have undoubtedly seen a closed-circuit television, either in a library, in someone's home. It's perhaps the most common type of electro-optical system. There are many new types of systems out there now, the flipper and the Geordie, more advanced systems that you actually wear on your head to magnify. But the bottom line is that all these systems have something in common. They give you magnification through electronics. So it is the electronics that give you the magnification that you're going to be using. So to review briefly and in conclusion, there are four types of magnification. We can magnify the size by physically making it larger. We can magnify through distance by bringing it closer and then providing optics which will focus it at that close distance. We can provide magnification through angular strategy, which is an example of a telescope. And lastly, we can provide magnification through an electro-optical system, also known as a closed-circuit television.